we are celebrating World Heart Day. So I have a message for everyone. You need to be stay healthy and stay fit. So nowadays we are seeing more of a heart attack and other diseases related to heart very commonly. So there are certain factors out there where the heart disease is more prevalent. So one is genetic factor is there. If you are in the genes, it is there, it will come to you. And there are high chances that if your father and mother has heart disease or heart attack in the previous years, then there are high chances that you will get a heart attack in future. The other thing is dietary factors. So dietary factor plays very much role, and that is where you can control the risk factor. So increase in carbohydrate or increase in fat intake will increase into the lipid deposition into the arteries. The coronary arteries are usually small, the brain arteries are usually small. The same way, the chances of getting heart attack is more if your lipids and cholesterol is high. The third thing is exercise, which is also under your control. So if you don't do exercise, the fat will get deposited into the body. And this same fat will get deposited into the arteries, and the chances of getting a heart attack is more. So lack of exercise definitely will increase the chances of heart attack. Third thing is alcohol. So if you drink alcohol more, it's empty calories. Same, it will increase your fat storage in the body. And again, it's the same thing. So you need to cut down on alcohol. Last thing is smoking. Smoking also is dangerous. The smoking contains nicotine. Nicotine affects the arteries. So same way, the coronary arteries are very small. So that is the reason the arteries gets affected more commonly. The other arteries are also affected, but these are the arteries which get affected more commonly. So these are the common risk factors we see. Apart from this, there are other risk factors are there, like congenital. Congenital means by birth, some patients will have a heart defects. So most commonly it is called, in a layman's term, as a hole in the heart. There are various types of defects are there. Hole is there, septum is not communicated, connections are different. But these are the diseases which we normally screen when the mother is pregnant. We do some fetal echocardiogram and we can screen those, and then we can detect it, which are more complex. The commoner ones or the small defects we can't detect in those patients. Another group of patients we see is degenerative heart diseases. In this one, the valve diseases are diseases comes. So the valve, normally they are born with a good valve, but over the period of time the valve get deteriorated. It might be because of some rheumatic heart disease in their childhood, which has caused damage to the heart valves, and the valve starts leaking, or the valve starts becoming thicker and thicker, and then it causes narrowing of the valve. So these are the diseases are there. The other diseases in the valve disease itself, those are senile degenerative heart diseases. These are called senile because it is seen in older population. So these patients, because of the wear and tear, the valve get damaged, and then it becomes thick. The valve get calcified, it becomes very stiff, and it doesn't open properly. So these are the diseases which are common. We do surgeries for these ones, but the surgery is a cure. So prevention is in your hand. So you need to prevent by doing regular exercises, cutting on the fatty and oily foods, eating green leafy vegetables, cutting down on alcohol, no smoking, and regular exercise and walking. So stay healthy and stay fit. Thank you.